The leadership of the Joint Readiness Training Center in Fort Polk was recently transferred from Brigadier General Timothy McGuire to Brigadier General Gary Brito during a change of command ceremony held May 4th at Warrior Field. With local and state dignitaries, veterans, special guests, soldiers, and family members bearing witness, the United States Army Forces Command Deputy Commanding General, Lieutenant General Patrick Donahue, accepted the installation colors from the outgoing McGuire and passed them along with the mantle of responsibility to incoming Brito. General Donahue commended McGuire for his accomplishments during his command, including the sheer number of troops trained.
Under his leadership, JRTC has trained 13 brigade-sized units under his watch. In just over a year, this organization has trained over 82,000 soldiers. That's, you know, pretty amazing, Tim.
In his final address to the Fort Polk team, General McGuire thanked guests, lauded the leaders and soldiers on the field, and discussed the metaphoric materials and tools needed to forge the warrior spirit.
As you look in the entrance to our headquarters, there's a hammer and an anvil, and it's symbolic of what forging the warrior spirit is all about. For that warrior spirit is like steel, a finely honed blade, ready to do what's required to win in battle. The leaders you see in front of you are that hammer.
Brigadier General Brito brings to Fort Polk a sense of humility as he takes the reins as leader of the post.
I am extremely proud and humbled to join in your ranks, and I promise you, my very best efforts every day. And likewise, count on you to bring your best efforts every day, and I know you will.
The change of command is just the beginning of General Brito's time at the Home of Heroes as he looks forward to continuing to forge the warrior spirit. Reporting for the Fort Polk Public Affairs Office, I'm Jeff England.